In this series of tutorials, we're going to recreate the menu from the UberMenu demo site. So you can see this menu demonstrates a wide range of the features of UberMenu. We've got flyout menus, mega menus, images in our submenus, advanced content, tabbed content, dynamic content, as well as a menu that's got a variety of those things all combined together. And so throughout this series, we'll go through each section of the menu individually and recreate it. Now before we really jump in, I'll just go through each of these menus and give you a quick overview of what they are. The flyout menu is just like a normal menu that you're used to. The difference between this and another menu is that its submenu type is simply set to flyout instead of mega. The rest of these menus are all mega menus, just with different contents. So this is a standard mega menu that you would normally be familiar with. The second level menu items are arranged into columns, and the third level menu items create the contents within those columns. In the images menu submenu, this is again a mega menu. It's just got four items in it, and each of them have an image that's aligned above the item title. And it also has this special content below where I've just noted a little bit about the images. The advanced submenu is also a mega submenu. It has two items in it. They're both custom content. On the left, we have a custom content block with a map shortcode in it. And on the right, we have a custom content block with a contact form 7 form in it. Again, we'll go through all these things in much greater detail in all of these tutorials, but I just want to give you a quick overview. The tab submenu has a tab element within it, and then additional items within that tab structure to create this. And the content that appears in this tab content panel, so this entire block is a set of tabs. The tab toggles appear on the left, but you can also make them appear on the top or the bottom or the right. And then each tab has a submenu, which becomes the toggle content panel. And inside this content panel, you can have any type of content, just like you can have in any of the mega submenus. In these submenus, we've created a similar effect to the images submenu. And in the dynamic submenu, again, this is a mega submenu, and these items are automatically generated, and we'll get into that in further detail in the dynamic submenus tutorial. These items on the right are, again, just normal menu items. They just happen to be aligned to the right edge of the menu. These two items have a special setting on them called mini item checked, which reduces their width. And then these just have icons assigned and their text disabled, but they're just like normal menu items. And here we have another icon menu item. The icon is just set to the magnifying glass, and its submenu has custom content, which is a search bar. Then in the works, we again have a set of tabs, and as you can see, this is what I meant with the submenu, or the content panel of each tab can have any type of content in it. Here we have a variety of columns. This one has an image to the left, but again, these are each just columnized menu content. So you can see the variety of different ways you can customize each submenu area. All right, so in this first tutorial, we're going to focus on just creating the top level menu bar. So of course, in your menu, each of these menu items is going to link to a particular page on your site. So if we click on Mega Menu, you'll see it brings us to the Mega Menu page. And if we go to our demo site that we'll be recreating here, you'll see that I already have a variety of pages set up. We'll be adding these to the menu. I also have some custom post type items. These items are exactly like posts. They have taxonomies or categories that they've been organized into. And you can add all these types of items to your menu as well. Doesn't really matter if they're normal posts, pages, or custom post types. But these will be the items that we're adding into the menu. So to start off building this top level, let's go to our menus panel. And let's start off with a completely fresh menu. Give it a name, hit create menu. All right, now we're working with a fresh menu. Now when we actually save this menu, we're gonna want to assign it to our primary navigation theme location. You could also do the same thing by going up to the Manage Locations tab and setting that here. So first let's add our top level pages, which we see are the Works, Flyout, Mega Menu, Images, Advanced, Tabs, Dynamic. So the Works is just going to be a home page that we'll change the navigation label on. All right, so we'll add all these to the menu and then drag them into the order we want them. Now let's rename each of them like we have on the demo site. So the Works Flyout Mega Menu. So all I'm doing is expanding these items to reveal the core WordPress options for the menu. This doesn't really have anything to do with Uber menu just yet. The navigation label is what actually appears on the front end of the site. Also, before we get too far into this, I just want to make you aware there's the Screen Options tab in the WordPress menus panel allows you to reveal or hide a variety of things on the menus panel. So first of all, you may not see all the different types of posts that you have on the left here, and you can reveal them up here. So if I check posts, you'll see that now I have the ability to add all my different posts, and I can hide it again by unchecking it. There are a variety of custom post types here that you may or may not want to be able to add to your menu, and yours will look different than mine. These are just what's on this demo site. But by clicking them, you'll reveal those options here. So, we've created a basic menu here, and we've renamed our menu items with the labels that we'd like to use. So I'm going to click Save Menu. Now if we look at our homepage, you see this is the menu we've created so far. We don't have any submenus because we've only created top-level items. And you can see the Works, Flyout, Mega Menu, Images, Advanced, Tabs, Dynamic. And if we click on one of these pages, it'll bring us to that page. So let's start by just adding an icon to the Works menu item. To do that, we'll click the Uber button on the Works to open the menu item settings. Click the item tab, I'm sorry, the icon tab. Click set icon, and we just have it set to this gear. Now you can also filter the icons if you want. So if you were looking for like a Twitter icon, start typing Twitter and you'll see the available options. But let's leave it set to a gear. If you want to unset the icon, just click the remove icon button in the bottom right. Now you'll see that the You're getting a little warning here that the settings have changed. So click Save Menu Item. Each of the menu item settings are saved independently, so you have to remember to click that for each item. But it's saved via AJAX, so you don't have to actually refresh the page every time you want to make a little change to your menu. So now if we refresh the front end, see, there's our icon on the works. All right, let's go back to the menu that we're recreating. So let's add our Twitter, Facebook, and search icons. These are just going to be links to external sites. So we'll create our, a link allows us to create a menu item that links to any URL we want, as opposed to a particular piece of content on your site. So we'll just link to twitter.com, and we'll say that our link text is Twitter. We're not actually going to use that, but it's still useful to label it that way so that you know what item you're looking at when it's just sitting in your menu. All right, so add that to the menu. Well, before I do anything else, let's save this so you can see what it looks like. All right, so now you see we've got our Twitter item here. And if we click it, we'll go to twitter.com. Okay. But what we obviously want to do is make it look like this. So it's just an icon, and we also want to put this nice hover color on it. So let's do that now. First thing we'll do is open the Uber menu options for the Twitter menu item. Go to the icon. We'll set it to the Twitter icon. Once I do that, you'll see that the Twitter icon shows up, but we don't want the words there, the word Twitter there. So we'll go to the general settings and click the disable text option. That means just the icon will show up, not the text. Okay, so now we have a link with just an icon. And we also want to align it to the right edge of the menu. So let's go to alignment. And if we leave it on automatic, it'll line up with everything else in the menu. And if we want to switch it to right so that it'll appear on the right edge. The other thing we want to do is make this a little narrower. There's a kind of a lot of padding on it. So we could come here and adjust the padding manually, but it's easier in this instance. There's a special setting if you just want sort of smaller menu items, and that's this mini item setting. By doing that, it'll reduce the horizontal padding to that. All right, I think the last thing we need to do is just set the hover color. So we'll go to our Customize Style panel. We'll set the background color for when this item is active. And let's see, the Twitter color is sort of a light blue. You can obviously be as precise as you want, but we're just gonna guess for the moment. Save that. Now you can see when we hover, this menu item turns blue. All right, so let's add the Facebook icon in the same way. Add a link. Link to Facebook. Obviously, you'd put the URL to your actual page as opposed to just Facebook's homepage. Edit our settings, we'll disable the text, align it to the right, make it a mini item, set the icon to Facebook, and then customize the style and set the active background color to a Facebook-y sort of blue. Save all those settings. And then don't forget, we haven't actually saved the menu yet. So if I refresh the front end menu right now, nothing's changed because we haven't actually saved the Facebook item yet. So we need to save the menu to actually add the Facebook item. Then when we refresh the homepage, our Facebook item will appear, and it's got our blue hover color. All right, now we'll add this search icon. So we'll add another link. This time, we're actually not going to link to anything at all. So I'll just set the URL to a pound sign. You have to set it to something. This may have changed, but WordPress, at least historically, has not let you add a link without anything in the URL. All right, so let's start by, we'll save that. All right, so you can see now we have our search button here. It doesn't link to anything, it's just a hash sign. So we're gonna do the same basic idea. We wanna disable the text. This time we're also going to disable the link because we don't want this to do anything when we click on it. You could make this a mini item, but I've chosen not to. I think it looks better with the full padding on the search button. Set our alignment to the right. Change the icon to the search icon. All right, so let's save those settings. All right, here now you see our search button. Now obviously you see that these are not in the order that we were expecting. So when you float elements to the right, they're going to be in their reverse order because that's how right floating works. So if we want to get the same order, Twitter, Facebook, search, what we'll want to do, and I'm just going to hit escape to toggle this. You can also close it with this button, but escape will toggle the menu item settings up and down. We're just going to reverse the order here. So search, Facebook, Twitter. Resave the order, and now we've got the order that we're looking for. Now while we're at it, let's create the submenu for the search bar as well. So you can see in our demo, when we hover over this item, we get this nice search bar. So you can actually do this with a short code built into Uber Menu. All right, so there are actually instructions for this in the knowledge base. So you need to look this up. Just pull up the Uber Menu 3 knowledge base. We want to create a search bar, so we'll search for search. Click on this article, and you'll see that we can add a search bar in the top level, but what we want to do is add a search bar in a submenu. So the first thing we're going to do is add a custom menu item, to which will create a submenu, and that's going to house our search bar shortcode. So you can copy the shortcode right out of here. So we'll open up the Uber Menu advanced items. We're going to add a custom content item. We want to make it appear when we hover over search, so we're going to make it a submenu item of search. Then we're going to open up the menu item settings. You'll see that they look a bit different for custom menu items. And you'll see that we have this custom content box where we can paste pretty much anything we want short of PHP, so we can put HTML or short codes in here. So let's paste that short code that we copied. And let's just see what we have out of the box. Don't forget to save the menu now that we've added a new menu item. Refresh. All right. So here's what we see out of the box. Obviously, this isn't quite what we wanted. This looks much slicker. So there are a few things here. The first most obvious one is that, well, as soon as we get a submenu, we're going to see this submenu indicator. And on most menu items, we'd want that, but on the search, we don't really want that. So in the search items settings, we'll scroll down. You'll see there's a setting, disable submenu indicator, the arrow. Check that. All right, so now we still have a submenu, but we don't have the submenu indicator anymore, which looks a bit nicer. Next, we have this with full width submenu, and we could leave it like that if we wanted to, but it's kind of overkill for this, for a search bar. So what we're going to do is, again, in the searches menu item settings, we'll click the submenu tab. This controls the submenu of the search item, and we are going to change the position of the submenu. So right now it's set to full width by default. That's why it appears at the full width of the menu bar. And we're going to change that to right edge of the menu bar. And save that. All right, so that's a bit better. Now our menu item appears, our submenu appears over to the right. So if we click in here, you see there's still a bunch of padding around this search bar, and we don't really need that we don't really want that in this case. So in the settings for the custom item, we'll uncheck pad custom content. So now the submenu is basically just the search bar. Now by default, the submenu is has a minimum width of 50%. So you can see it's taking up half the search bar. Half the menu bar. So what we can do is just in most cases, your submenu will be at least that wide. In this case, we have an extra narrow submenu. So what we'll do is open up the search items submenu settings again. And we'll just change the submenu's minimum width to 1 pixel, because again, this is a minimum width. So that means it should just size to our search bar's width. Refresh that. Now you can see the submenu is just the size of the search bar. We can also do a bit extra here if we want. We can change the placeholder. Change that text to whatever we like. Now you can see the placeholder text is entered to search. All right, so we've pretty much recreated the menu bar at this point. And in the subsequent tutorials, we'll recreate the submenus one by one.